Okay, everyone. Long-awaited moment. Avengers Age of Ultron Hulkbuster. It's freaking huge. Wow. Oh, let's crack it open. I'm pretty sure that there's 888 made of these. And we'll find out what number I've got. Okay, so we got 794 of 888. Okay, wow. Very good quality box. There's latches on both sides. And you've even got a spot on the latches. You can put padlocks. That's pretty cool. Before I do this. Don't laugh because this is hard to take off by yourself. I'm going to attempt to set this whole thing up on my own. I reckon I can do it, so I'll give it a good hot crack. Yeah. drinking alcohol, so heads up. Comes with a little plaque. And you've got the instructions. I was pretty excited to get this statue, so the amount of times I've watched reviews on this and unboxings, I've got a fair idea on how to put it together now. Holy crap! I'm gonna give you guys a look. This is amazing. Definitely want to film all of the unboxing, as if there's any damage, there will be proof. Good advice. This is the biggest statue I own now. Wow. It's just amazing. So this is the piece. Sits at the front of the statue. It's part of one of the arms. Pretty sure it's the one that wraps around Hulk's arm and gets ripped off at some point. These things do have a bit of weight behind them. So it is recommended putting this statue together with a couple of people. I'm gonna be a dumbass and just do it on my own. Just checking for damage, guys. Last thing you want to do is go and pay $6,000 Australian for a busted up statue. Nothing I can see. One's all pretty good. This is his right arm. And this is the left arm that I'll be displaying. This is the hammer fist. Which has a light up function on the top there. Yeah, these are pretty pretty weighty. I think they Queen Studio could have gone the whole hog and put a light up feature in that palm area at the pulse blaster. That would have just knocked it out of the park then. Not to say that this isn't freaking amazing. Going to take out the second part and have a look at the big boy himself. Whew. Middle of summer in Western Australia at the moment. Got the aircon on, but it's still warm. Okay, let's give you guys a look. Now there's nothing that I can see that's damaged. It's all pretty bloody solid. It's all moving as one. Now I did watch a unboxing last night that the guy unboxed it and it hadn't been QC'd. Poor bugger. That was only minor little details, little chips and paint errors, but I mean, that guy was waiting, I think, a year or so, maybe more. He didn't seem too fazed by that, so. And to be honest, I wouldn't be either. It's battle damaged, so you can get away with that. Whereas if it was a clean as a whistle, bloody, no nicks, damage or anything, yeah, you're going to probably notice that. All right, I am going to put the top back on this, and seeing that I'm doing this on my own, I'm going to pack this back on,
leave the arms out, flip the whole box over, and do it that way. That way I can get to the big boy himself a bit easier. I don't have to reach over this box and break my back. All right.